Sometimes Photoshop behaves strangely, which is a strong indication of damaged preferences file. What is the preferences file in Photoshop, by the way? The preferences file is where Photoshop stores all the settings, also known as Photoshop settings file. If the Photoshop setting file is damaged for some reasons, it causes the Photoshop to act strangely, and the best way is to reset the preference files to its default. But before you do that, keep this in mind that you will lose all your current settings and Photoshop will be reverted back to its default settings like once it was installed. Which means you will lose your workspace settings, scratch disk settings, tool settings, color settings, etc. So the best approach is to ensure it's really the preferences file which causes the problem, not the tools or anything else. For example, if one of your tools is acting strangely, let's suppose it's brush in this case, simply go to brush settings and click on this small icon here and reset the tool, and that will resolve the problem. Secondly, if any of the tools or panels or the side toolbars is missing, for example, if I take the layer out and I remove it and I can't find that panel back in, so the best way is simply go to Windows and Workspace and reset Workspace. So whatever workspace you are having, simply reset the workspace from here and you will get the panels back. Otherwise, you can find any of the panel from here. But if you are not familiar with Photoshop, so simply go to Windows, Workspace and reset Essential Default and you will get all those settings back to its original state. In most cases, these two quick fixes can resolve the problem. But if your problem still exists, it means it's time to reset the Photoshop setting file, also known as preferences file. There are two ways to do it. First, automatically, and second, manually, which is recommended. In first option, Photoshop will reset the preferences file automatically. All you gotta do is simply press Ctrl, Alt, and Shift from the window and Command, Option, and Shift for the Mac users. Just place your fingers on top of these three buttons. Don't press them now. First, you gotta do is just simply launch the Photoshop. And once you click on it, immediately after pressing the three keys together. And once you do that, you will get message like this. So in my case, I'm not going to press yes because my Photoshop is working fine. But you gotta press delete this Adobe Photoshop settings file. And when you press yes, the Photoshop will erase its settings files. And once the Photoshop is launched, a new Photoshop preferences file has been created. And hopefully after this, your Photoshop will start working the way it should. But in this case, I'm going to press no because my Photoshop is working fine. And I'm going to show you the second way, which is the recommended way. If I was you, I shall do it manually because if I do it manually, I shall have the option to backup my existing preference file while creating a new one. Which means after creating the new preferences file, if my problem still exists, I can go back to my previous backup settings. Let's see how can I do that manually. Simply go to the drive where you have installed the Photoshop. In my case, I have installed Photoshop in C drive. And after that, go to users. So whichever user you have, simply go to your user. And here you should see the folder called app data. If the folder is not visible, make sure you go to view and click on this hidden item because the folder we are looking for is hidden. Once you click the hidden item, you can see the app data folder. Simply double click on it and go to roaming. And then Adobe, and then go to whichever Photoshop you are using. I'm using Photoshop 2020, so I double click on this. And here Adobe Photoshop 2020 settings, double click on it. And this is the file we are looking for. Adobe Photoshop 2020 preferences.psp file. So I suggest simply remove this file from here. Don't copy it. Just simply cut this file from here and paste it somewhere else, maybe on the E drive or any other drive. Simply remove this file from here and place it to any other location in case if we need to get them back again. So if you remove this, so in your case, remove this file from here. So what happens when you launch the Photoshop again, Photoshop will try to find the preferences file from this directory. And once the Photoshop can't find the file, it will create a default settings file. And that settings file would be default settings files like the one you installed the Photoshop newly. And for the Mac user, you can see the path on the screen now. And to ensure, you can see the hidden folder from the library folder. I hope after following this tutorial, your Photoshop will start working the way it should. But if your problem still exists, then I suggest please contact the Adobe Help Support. The link is in the description below. If you have any question, please drop the line into the comment section. And if you are here first time on this channel, please do consider subscribing and hit the like button. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye now.